Namaskar. I'm Suruchi Das and you're watching Rhythm News. When justice faces the flames, who will guard the guardians? In a dramatic turn in Uttar Pradesh politics, Samajwadi Party Chief Akhilesh Yadav, while taking a jab at Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath's bulldozer policies, overlooked a darker truth within his own ranks. Yadav, while campaigning for SP candidate Naseem Solanki in Sisamau, cited the recent Supreme Court's ruling curbing the state's bulldozer actions. He expressed relief that the bulldozer will be parked, hinting at a win for justice. But what about the actions of his own party's former MLA, Irfan Solanki, convicted of encroachment and arson? The irony here is potent. Solanki, once a sitting MLA in the Sisamau constituency, was sentenced to 7 years in prison for setting fire to a widow's home over a land dispute. His conviction, coupled with numerous other allegations of violence, speaks volumes. Despite Solanki's proven record of aggression, including threats and even violence against a widow, Yadav now campaigns for his release. This curious selective justice raises serious questions about Akhilesh Yadav's stance on law and order. Solanki's case is no isolated incident within the SP. In fact, Akhilesh Yadav's party roster appears tainted by individuals within extensive criminal records. Mohammed Abdullah Azam Khan, for instance, faces allegations ranging from kidnapping to extortion. Nahid Hassan, another party member, stands accused of attempted murder and robbery. This isn't mere political banter. These are criminal charges that stain the reputation of any political organization. Even Shivpal Singh Yadav, embroiled in years-long internal power struggles, symbolizes SP's inability to foster discipline or reform within its ranks. And let's not forget Gayatri Prajapati, a former mining minister, ousted briefly on corruption charges under Yadav's own tenure, yet re-embraced when convenient. From alleged corruption to outright physical aggression, SP's core members paint a starkly different picture than the one Yadav presented on stage. Yadav's praise for judiciary also rings hollow given his endorsement of individuals actively undermining it. Yadav's public gratitude for the court's bulldozer decision glosses over Solanki's own brazen disregard for property and life. A disregard further amplified by SP's backing of Solanki's wife for the Sisamau by-election. Historically, Solanki's record with law extends beyond arson, from assaulting doctors over a minor traffic incident in 2014 to mistreating a female IAS officer in 2011. His criminal pattern is well documented. These aren't mere accusations, but events that have sparked outrage and concern across Uttar Pradesh. As India observes this unfolding narrative, it becomes clear that for SP, justice may be less about reform and more about convenience. Where Yogi Adityanath's administration uses bulldozers, right or wrong, in a hardline approach to maintaining law and order, Yadav's SP risks becoming a symbol of lawlessness and impunity. The court's decision may restrict bulldozers, but will it also restrain criminal affiliations from influencing politics? Jai Hind.